I was wrong. I was wrong about a lot of things, but most importantly, Jeremy Clarkson's contract is not being renewed at the end of the season, which I don't even know what that means because the season already ended prematurely. But obviously, you can go to BBC for more accurate information other than just some dude talking in his garage. What I wanted to talk about was the fact that that comes as a surprise to me. I think everything I've said so far is completely incorrect. But what struck me as funny, absolutely funny, is what I did say is if it was the United States. Now, I'm not trying to backtrack, but some of the keywords that were used in the president or the whatever, the director of BBC, some of the keywords that really stuck out in his three-point statement was honor, respect, integrity, BBC, something. Those words aren't used in American media. Those are not, I mean, maybe somebody trying to talk like they're CNN or something, but CNN doesn't have car shows. Or if they do, they're extremely boring and nobody watches them. Now, I am not a car reviewer. I will review cars every so often, but they're normally mine. Which brings the question, the big shitstorm that everybody's going to be watching for is, who would you choose to replace Jeremy Clarkson? I have no idea who I would choose. I really don't have an opinion on that in terms of like a person that I personally, a person I particularly enjoy seeing on TV. A lot of car reviewers that I see get under my skin, but not because of them. It's car reviewing. So in the comments, let me know, let each other know, argue, kill each other, I don't care, on who you think would be the best replacement or the best dream team for making the UK version of Top Gear as good as it is now.